Hi, this is Linda from NYC Single Mom, and we're here with Megan McDonald, the author of the Judy Moody series, very popular in our household.
Oh, good.
Yes, my daughter is 8 years old, second grade.
Yes.
So this is the year of Judy Moody.
Yay!
I wish that she did not have ballet today because I would have loved for her to have met Jordana and you,
but
another time. So here, I have just a few questions for you. So your first experience as a writer was like 10 years old, right?
Well,
according to your bio, I don't know if that's true or not. That was your first experience.
It is. I mean, I was a reader, I think, first before I was a writer, and my favorite book growing up was Harriet the Spy. So my mom got me this little spiral notebook when she gave me the book, because Harriet's a reporter and she lives in Manhattan. She spies on all her neighbors and stuff. And she said, I had started to stutter when I was about 10 years old, because I have four older sisters and I could never get a word in. And so my mom had this idea. She'd give me this notebook, and I was inspired by Harriet. And I just started writing everything down in the notebook. So that was... that's what I remember kind of as my beginnings of trying to express yourself as a writer.
And would you recommend that for, you know, an eight or nine-year-old?
Absolutely. I think it's really important for kids to have fun with writing. Mm-hmm. You know, just keep a journal or make up a book with your friends that you're writing and illustrate the pictures, because sometimes... I talk to kids who feel like writing is a chore or something they have to do for school, and I just wish kids could have fun with it. It's such a great way of storytelling.
Yeah, I would agree with you. My daughter loves to write.
Oh, good, good.
She loves to read.
Yeah.
But I'm trying to get her into more of the writing, sort of like, what did you read, you know, and just come up with your own stories.
Yeah.
And I think when they're sort of left to their own devices, they definitely come up with their own stories, which I think is fun.
Exactly, and I think as a reader, too, that really inspires you, because whether you know it or not, you kind of just take in how a story is formed, you know?
So here is the... for new young readers, since my daughter's in second grade, so tell us, how did Judy Moody come about? What's the history of Judy?
Well, I'd say originally, when I first wrote Judy Moody, I had about maybe... 15 different stories that were just episodes, and they were all based on, I have four older sisters, so they were just based on funny things I did, you know, growing up with sisters, and I was writing them down, and then I thought, you know, it would be fun to, so I had this character of the bossy big sister, and I knew I wanted her to have a lot of moods, but I thought it'd be really fun to give her a little brother.
Yeah.
And that way it wouldn't be so close to my life. I could really use imagination and have it, you know, be a little bit different from life. So so the early books have a lot of true stories in them of things that really happened. Like the Toad Pea Club is a real club that my sisters had, and the trick with the hand in the toilet. But I think just the sibling dynamics, everyday family stuff, that all comes from my own growing up.
And how did they feel in the beginning when you started to write about... sort of them, kind of.
You mean Judy and Sting, when I first started writing?
Yeah.
Well, I was having so much fun because they're very funny books, hopefully make you laugh. And so it was kind of fun because I could take something every day, but I could exaggerate it a little bit. You know, Judy is...